In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Tails on a USB flash drive. It's actually a very simple installation and the documentation on the Tails website is very good. But the big question is, why would you want to do this? Tails is recommended by the author of this book, Extreme Privacy, What It Takes to Disappear. It's recommended by others, including Edward Snowden, the co-founder of the Tor Project, as well as the Electronic Frontier Foundation. Now, if you already know what Tails is and all you're interested in seeing is the installation process, then jump to this timestamp. But what is Tails? It's essentially a portable operating system that runs off a USB flash drive. When your computer is shut down, everything is lost. It's an ephemeral operating system. In other words, all the information is loaded into memory or RAM. When power is lost or the computer is shut down, everything is lost. Now, you can create some persistency on the flash drive if you want to. So on the Tails website, they actually explain this really nicely. They tell you that this leaves no trace on your computer. It allows you, as an example, to use someone else's computer. So this is a Windows laptop, but I perhaps don't trust Windows. Windows could have viruses on it, it could have a keylogger, it could have some other kind of software running on it. So I boot into Tails, runs in RAM. When the computer is shut down, everything is lost. So as they show you on the website, it has amnesia. Everything you do disappears once you shut the computer down, but you can have persistent storage. So as an example, why would you want to do that? Because you want to keep persistency of your documents, as an example, or your Wi-Fi passwords, or your browser bookmarks. It's not required that you do that, but the thing about the persistent storage is it's encrypted. Only someone who knows the password of that encrypted storage can access those persistent documents, and you don't have to use them if you don't want to. The browser shown here is Tor. All your traffic is pushed through Tor, passing through three relays. The whole idea here is to make your traffic anonymous so that people can't see what you're doing. Tails allows you to avoid online surveillance and censorship. Who would be interested in using this? Well, anyone perhaps who's interested in extra privacy in the world today where we are tracked so much. Other examples would be activists, journalists and their sources, domestic violence survivors. Basically, Tails is fantastic if you want a secure operating system that's ephemeral, where everything is lost once you reboot your computer. As an example, I'll power off this computer. Everything is gone. I can take this out. And then if I turn my computer on again, so once this reboots, it will boot into Windows. As you can see there, it's starting up and we've booted into Windows. So Tails is running entirely off this USB flash drive. It's ephemeral. Everything is lost when you reboot. Okay, but that's enough talking. Let me show you how to get Tails installed. Okay, so I've booted into Windows. I've gone to the Tails website. What I need is a USB flash drive, which I've got here. I'll use the same one that I actually installed Tails on. We'll just overwrite the information on the flash drive. Click on the Install Tails menu option. In my example, I'm using Windows to do the installation. You could do the installation using macOS or Linux as an example, or the terminal, but I'm just going to use Windows for this example because most people that watch my videos use Windows. I personally use Windows, Mac, Linux, different operating systems because they all have advantages and disadvantages. So we told you that you need a USB stick, you need Windows 7 or later, you need at least 2 gig of RAM, and they say you need a smartphone, but you don't actually need that for the installation. And then what we're gonna do firstly is download Tails. So we're gonna download the image. It's about 1.3 gig in size, so I'll download that. I've actually previously downloaded it just in preparation for this video, and I was running it on this USB flash drive before. So let's see how long that takes to download. Now, we are warned that Tails is safe, but it's not magic. You've got to realize that there are limitations of the Tor network. There's certain things that you shouldn't do. So have a look at their warnings. Don't do dumb things. Don't make these beginner mistakes and lose the whole power of Tails. So you can read that in your own time. The next thing we need to do is verify the download. So once you've downloaded Tails, they want you to verify that it's actually a good installation. So I'll do that using the file that I previously downloaded. So click open, and that will basically verify your download to make sure that it hasn't been corrupted. Okay, so we're told there that there's a problem with the download, and that's because it's an old download. Notice here the verification also fails if you try to verify a different download than the latest version of Tails. So that version I actually downloaded yesterday and it failed the verification process. So what I'll do now is select my new version. So it's actually this version, 5.16, and click open. And there you go, the verification was successful. So we were able to prove that we actually downloaded the right version of Tails. Now what we're gonna do is download Etcher so that we can write the image to our flash drive. And then we told basically to open up Etcher to do the installation. Okay, so there you go. Etcher Portable has been downloaded. So I'll open up the application. It's picked up the USB SanDisk flash drive. So that's the device I'm going to write to. I'm going to flash this new version of Tails. So 5.16 at the time of this recording. Click open and click flash. And that'll basically flash it to the USB flash drive. You can see it's about 17% at the moment. Okay, it's been written and now it's validating.
You get the idea.
Okay, there you go. Flash completed, we're told. So we're done now. On the Tails website, we're told that we're all done. Now, something I didn't mention is your flash drive is going to be overwritten. So just be aware that if you've got anything important on that flash drive, you should back it up because it's going to be wiped and then overwritten. Okay, so we're done now. They tell us that we can do other things, but we don't really need to do this. We can click on start and use shift at the same time when restarting the machine to allow us to select that it boots from the USB flash drive. I'm not going to do that. For this example, I'm simply going to click restart. And then what I'll do is I'll press F2, which is the keystroke for this laptop, to get it to boot into BIOS. This really depends on the laptop. We have created some documentation, the PDF which you can download, that helps you perhaps set up this installation. But it's actually a very simple installation. And the Tails website is very good. So I pressed F2. And now I should be able to boot off the USB flash drive. Notice what happens. It didn't show the USB flash drive. And that's because it's recommended that you don't insert the USB flash drive when Windows is powered on. And it actually ejected, if you like, the USB flash drive. So what I need to do is I need to redo this. So I'm going to save and exit. And then I'm going to press F2 again after inserting the USB flash drive again to make sure that it boots from that USB flash drive. And notice now it's picked it up. So I'm going to move the flash drive to position 1. Your BIOS will obviously vary. So you need to check the settings of your laptop and the BIOS settings. Something else to be aware of, under advanced mode, you may need to go to security and disable secure boot. So that's already disabled on my laptop because I've already done this previously. But you may have to disable secure boot. And then what I'm going to do is save my changes, click OK, and hopefully that should now boot into Tails. And there you go. We can boot directly into Tails or use other options. I'll just let it go to the default. Okay, so when it boots up, you have various options. You can specify your language, your keyboard layout, etc. And one of the options is to create persistent storage. So if you want persistent storage, you can specify that here and then click Start Tails. And then you need to specify a password for your persistent storage. I'll use a very bad password of password. Obviously, you're going to want to use something much better than that. But the idea is that you use a password to encrypt your persistent storage. You don't have to create that, but that does allow you, for instance, to keep your Wi-Fi passwords and your documents and so forth as mentioned. When Tails boots up, it also asks you about your Tor connection. Do you want to connect to Tor automatically? And in my case, I do. You can also get it to use a Tor bridge. And if you're not sure what these options are, it tells you what they are here. So Tor bridges are secret Tor relays. So use this as your first Tor relay if connections to Tor are being blocked. So for example, in some countries, by some public networks or by some parental controls. I don't have that problem here because this is my own network. I've actually not connected to the Wi-Fi. I'm connecting to a physical Ethernet cable. So I'm actually connected via this USB Ethernet connection. You've got to decide for yourself whether you want to use Wi-Fi. Obviously, in some places you'd need to do that and you may want to have extra privacy and security. So you check that option. And you can also hide to your local network that you're using Tor. So if you think that someone is monitoring the local network for Tor connections, you can use that. That's not really relevant for my example. So I'll just connect to Tor. And going back to persistent storage, notice you can specify various options in your persistent storage. I'm happy with the defaults. And as you can see here, we've now connected successfully to Tor, so we can start the Tor browser. You want to wait for that connection to succeed before you actually start Tor. But there you go. We've got Tails installed on this USB flash drive on this Windows laptop. I've booted into Tails. That gives me a secure operating system. So if I'm worried about viruses or keyloggers or other malicious software on this laptop, I can boot into Tails and not have to worry about that. My connections are secure in Tails because I'm pushing everything through Tor. It's obviously going to be a lot slower and you may have problems connecting to certain websites. So as an example, if I search for Social Blade, and just note it's using DuckDuckGo instead of Google for this, so much more privacy-oriented search engine. But I'm now going to Social Blade, and I have had problems actually on Social Blade in the past. It's not giving me problems here, which is great to see. But some websites may block Tor. But as an example, I can search for myself and look at the analytics of, for instance, my YouTube channel on Social Blade. And there you go. You can see number of views in the last 28 days of information relating to my YouTube channel. But the point is that I'm using Tor on a secure operating system. If I'm worried about something, so I need to shut my computer down, I can simply shut it down and everything is lost, except for that persistent storage, because Tails is running in memory. So everything is gone now. And if I pull that out and start up the computer, it'll boot back into Windows. And there you go, I'm back into Windows now because I've pulled out the USB flash drive. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bomble and I want to wish you all the very best. Go out there, stay safe and stay private.